Hey mamas, it's your Cajun Stork here. Are you considering delivering in a birth center and trying to figure out how that might be different than a hospital birth? Well, I'm here to tell you all about it as a midwife practicing in a birth center. But before I begin, my name is Midwife Kyra and I believe in truly natural birth because I know that it makes for better birth experiences. Consider subscribing to my YouTube channel and joining in today's conversation about birth center versus hospital births. So let's start talking first about a traditional hospital birth. There's a lot of things that people are familiar with in a hospital birth. You know, you're expecting to wear the hospital gown. You know that there's going to be nurses attending your birth. But many people may not realize that their doctor is not actually going to show up and labor beside them in their hospital birth like you would expect a midwife to do in a birth center birth. So let's talk about the things that are in common with a birth center birth and a hospital birth. Well, first of all, both a hospital and a birth center are facilities that you go to give birth in. Hospitals have other floors, obviously, where they're treating sick people, but they do have typically a labor and delivery floor where only well people go to either have their give birth or have their babies postpartum. Birth centers traditionally are freestanding, located outside of the hospital. Many hospitals have realized that with good marketing that they can say that they have a birth center in their hospital, but they still have to adhere to many of the hospital policies. So don't let the word birth center in the hospital fool you. It's not the same thing as a freestanding birth center. Now, a freestanding birth center is a standalone birth center meant for deliveries, prenatal education, like prenatal visits, postpartum, and newborn care outside of the hospital. Typically, moms will come in, have their baby, stay several hours postpartum, and go home. Another thing that's common in hospital births and birth center births is that there is a medical provider who is there to take care of you. Typically, in a hospital, that's a nurse. Out of hospital, it's a midwife, but they're there to monitor you the whole time that you're admitted to make sure you and your baby are healthy and progressing well. One of the major differences, however, is in a hospital, the physician may come by and check on you, but the physician doesn't labor beside you. And in fact, many women are surprised that their doctors don't even show up until the baby is crowning or nearly crowning, not when they start pushing. But in a birth center, when you're being monitored by midwives throughout your labor, when it comes time for your birth, your midwife is there with you, laboring beside you, and while you're pushing, in the room with you the entire time that you're pushing. And so this brings women a lot of comfort to have that continuity of care from their midwife for their birth center birth. In a hospital, you can expect to give birth in the bed, on your back, surrounded by your doctor, a nurse, or three, and if there's shift change, there could be several more. And if you're having any kind of possible complications, let's say you have meconium in the water or preterm especially, you can also expect the NICU team to be in the delivery with you. The baby is born. Most hospitals, I hope, at least in my area, are doing the immediate skin-to-skin. However, one of the things that I find is that they're not doing skin to skin in like that golden first hour way that you would expect. Their goal is literally to put the baby, their skin, on your skin. And I find that they spend a lot of time interrupting that first hour with aggressive towel rubbing of the baby and excessive vitals on a healthy baby. And oh gosh, I went to a birth earlier this year where the moment the mom lifted up the baby and put the baby on her chest, the nurse was like, hey ma'am, the pediatrician you chose doesn't take your insurance. Can you give me another pediatrician's name, please? And this all happened in like the first 60 seconds of holding her baby for the first time. And so all of that to say is, I feel like hospitals are on the right track, and especially when it comes to skin to skin. They're definitely on the right track when it comes to breastfeeding in Louisiana with the GIF certifications, but I feel like they're kind of missing some of the point when things are healthy and normal, and that's where birth centers come in. So when birth is normal, the less we do, the safer it is. You've heard me say this many times. And so when birth is normal, we are hands off. Skin to skin literally means baby to mom's chest and a quiet room and dim lights and peacefulness so that mom, dad, and baby can kind of bond and have their first moment. And my birth center isn't any more special than all the other birth centers, guys. Most birth centers who are freestanding practice this way, that we honor that first hour, that golden first hour. And in addition to that, there's a lot more hands-off in a birth center. You can deliver in whatever position you want, wherever you want in the room. You can get in the bed, you can get in the tub. It really doesn't matter. As long as things are progressing normally, the absolute last place your midwife wants you is delivering on the bed on your back. It slows things down. It makes you miserable. Nobody likes delivering on their back. Get off your back, right? Okay. So another thing that's really different about birth centers is the privacy. A lot of times you will know the staff who's coming to your birth before your birth, so there's no strangers. In my practice, I bring at least one birth assistant to the birth, often a nurse, who can whose sole responsibility is to care for the newborn after the birth with what we call NRP. This is neonatal resuscitation. In a hospital, there's a lot more going on. There's a lot larger of a staff, but in a birth center, it is a lot more private, quiet setting. A birth center is also more of a home-like setting in a hospital-like facility. So if you've seen my birth suites, you know that our birth suites look more like a bedroom than they do like a hospital suite. We have nice, peaceful colors. We have lighting with the intention of dim lighting. And even our IV pole is not a traditional IV pole. It's meant to fit more into a home-like environment, which helps take mom's stress levels down and help her feel really relaxed for her birth experience. Not that hospitals aren't trying, and I don't mean to like doubt the hospitals. They are doing a good job, but again, there's only so much they can do because they do have some policies that they have to meet that are just a little different than what birth center policies are required by the accreditation agency for birth centers. So typically in a hospital birth, you can expect to be sent home within 24 to 72 hours after you deliver, depending on the method of birth, your vaginal versus C-section. How long you were in labor, your water was broken, and what your group B strep status was, and if you received IV antibiotics. In a birth center setting, you can expect to go home within 6 to 12 hours of your birth, and expect frequent home visits in the postpartum. So actually, your midwife comes to you at your house while you're resting with your baby. And one of the commitments I make to my clients is that part of you being able to go home with your baby on day one is this open line of communication that you will call me even if it's 2 a.m. to come out if you're having a problem with you or your baby. And so clients go home sooner. They do their postpartum recovery in their house, which I know it might sound a little scary if you've never considered this before, but my clients love it, and most women do. There's nothing like recovering at your house without constant interruptions when you're in labor. Another main difference between a hospital birth and a birth center birth is the cost. You guys, hospital birth expenses are getting out of control with the excessive fees. I had a client go in the other day for an NST where they just monitored the baby for 30 minutes and they sent her home. They charged her $1,700 for 30 minutes of care. They did not do a vaginal exam. They did not give her an IV. I'm not even sure how many vitals they did on her. $1,700. And that's just the monitoring. Recently, I posted a Facebook post where I mentioned a recent local hospital birth, less than 12 hours, no medical intervention, just come in, have your baby, and be done, was costing their insurance company $17,000 just for the birth. This is not including the fee for the doctor, the postpartum, the newborn care. She had to pay for a blood bank, and she did not need a blood transfusion. It's just getting out of control. And so many people aren't really aware how much a hospital birth is going to cost them, because while they're pregnant, they're only paying towards their doctor's fee. And next thing you know, you're receiving bills for 364 days. And ultimately in this area, I believe that the average with insurance for a hospital birth is about $5,000 to $7,000, depending on your insurance coverage. And that's for when everything's normal and easy breezy. A birth center costs so much less, with a lot less interventions, a lot more quality care, hour-long prenatal appointments, continuous care during labor and birth. It just is a completely different medical expense. And it's just because we're able to charge less. And so that's one of the main differences, is you can deliver with better quality care and a lower fee in most cases. And who doesn't love that, right? So those are some of the major differences between a hospital birth and a birth center birth from this midwife's perspective. If you have other things you'd like to add, please post them in the comments below. Otherwise, I'd love for you to follow me to this video right here, where we're gonna talk about what is a midwife and why you may wanna consider your midwife for your upcoming birth. Thanks for watching this Midwife Monday. I'll see you next Monday. Bye-bye.